Hey folks, in this video we are going to explore the AS400 error, no X11 display variable was set. Connections to the mainframe AS400 databases is possible using Boomi's database connector, but you may run into the following no X11 display variable was set error. Please see our previous video on the basics of the AS400 video for more information. For reference, please double check the driver that you are using is appropriate, generally JD400.jar. The class name matches the documentation for that driver and the username and the password are correct. This error stems from a problem with the JDBC driver that is failing to connect to the AS400 database. The underlying cause is trouble passing the username and or password that is being sent to the AS400 database due to restrictions on the US username or password. Special characters are frequently the underlying cause, though it is dependent on the specific rules that have been set up for your AS400 database. This causes the driver to attempt to instantiate a GUI prompt for you to retry entering the password. The attempt to instantiate the GUI fails and then it returns this error to Boomi. You can verify this by attempting to connect to the database using a simple Java configuration tool. In the end, removing specific characters or accurately matching other restrictions should allow you to avoid this error. Please speak with your database admin and review the IBM rules for AS400 passwords. Lastly, now that your connection is secure, you may be able to perform scripting with your new AS400 connection from Boomi. To do this, you will want to create a new custom library component in the build tab like you did previously. Instead of setting the custom library type to connector, you'll want to choose scripting from the options. Reference the previously uploaded JD400.jar file and then save the new library. Create a package component using the button in your upper right hand corner and follow prompts to deploy this as a scripting jar. Similar to before, this will end up in the /userlib scripting directory instead of the /userlib/database directory. And that's it for this video. Thanks.